I think we're live. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the cave. This evening, we're going to hang out. We're going to talk about bow making, bow woods, and anything you have. It looks like we've got a few people already on. If you guys are on, you can go ahead and ask questions. But first, I wanted to start off talking about some bow woods because I get a ton of questions about bow woods. Now, the main question I get is, can I use a specific type of bow for a bow wood, like spruce or pine or oak or maple or red cedar, or, you know, on and on and on and on. There's a lot of people overseas who ask me questions about bow woods, and they'll ask questions and I have no clue even what the wood is. So I'm going to give some basic general rules that help you maybe discern or determine yourself what a good bow wood would be. Now, my opinion, if you've seen any of the Wheel Up Bow series, is that you can make a bow out of anything. You know, we've made a bow out of a pallet wood. We've made a bow out of, what was the other one? Oh, it was duct tape. We use duct tape to make a bow, and I've got some coming up on that. But you can make a bow out of anything, but the harder the wood you have, the longer the bow will last. And let me show you that poplar bow I made. I've had a lot of people say, like, that's a terrible choice of wood. And the truth is, it's not the best choice of wood, but it's a really cheap choice, and I can make a bow out of it. And this is the difference. So this is the poplar bow. You can see how it comes up like this. It used to be flat, but since it's a really light, soft wood, it has string fall is what it's called, or it has a little set in it. And so the limbs don't hold its original form, which loses some poundage over time. If you have a bow more like the Ipe bamboo back bow, it's going to hold its form pretty much forever. Every bow will lose a little bit, but that's the biggest difference in lighter woods to, softer woods to harder woods. So if you can just choose a harder wood and then put some kind of bow backing on it, that's going to work out well for you. Let's see who's on. Steve used pine on your first one. Me too. It's not, you can still make a decent bow out of it. Pine, spruce, will they bow? Yes, they will bow. I don't never use spruce. I'm pretty sure it's a pretty soft wood, but it's going to be the same as pine. What I would do the best is get the biggest backing you can get, even if it's like the fiberglass tape or whatever you end up using. Use the thickest bow backing possible, and that'll help you out a little bit, but there is limits to that soft kind of wood. Hey, Clayton. Maple, hickory, and osage. Yes, great recommendations. All of those fantastic bow woods. There's so many really good woods out there, and if you're doing that, you're gonna succeed for sure. How long does a poplar bow last? Great question. I've got it right here. I made this 2 months ago, I think, and we're still holding up. So, I mean, it's not very heavy poundage, but it still holds up. It still works. I think the biggest thing with how long a bow is going to last is going to be your tiller, depending on how good you can tiller. Like, that is more important than anything. And I didn't realize this when I started making bows. I just would get impatient in the tillering process and just take the bow down and go shoot it. But tillering is the most important thing. Every bow that's broken for me is basically because the tiller's bad. And what I mean by bad is both limbs aren't bending equally or evenly. If you can get both limbs to bend equally and evenly, you're going to be golden. But it's worth taking time, taking hours, whatever you need to take in order to get the tiller right. Because if you don't get the tiller right, the bow's going to break. So I would rather have a pine bow with a really good tiller than an Osage bow with a crappy tiller, I think. I might rather have the Osage bow with a crappy tiller and then re-tiller it. That's what I'd prefer. Daniel, your email about the cracked handle. I haven't seen it. I have somebody who helps me respond to emails because I get so many of them. So I'm going to try to answer your questions here instead of on email if it's about bow making. Compressing the fiberglass tape, an ace bandage will work really well actually on that. What you can do is you can wrap your fiberglass tape in some like saran wrap, wax paper, something like that, so that your ace bandage doesn't get, actually not saran wrap, that won't work. it depends what kind of glue you're using. If you're using wood glue, you need air to make it dry. And so you can use like an ace bandage to wrap it. If you're using some kind of epoxy, then it's okay to wrap it in saran wrap and then wrap it with anything after that. But yes, you can definitely wrap it on. You can definitely wrap the fiberglass tape on, and that's a good idea, especially if you have wood that has a crown on it that's not completely flat. Had any luck with ash from the dude? What's up, man? I've never used ash. I've heard fantastic things about it. I plan to use ash in the future. I've heard it's a good bow wood, but I've never personally have used it. Johnny says tillering is very important. I couldn't agree more. Ooh, can you steam the softer wood and change the shape? Yes, you can. And this is something that's super fun. And this is something you can explore. Like, you can get a PVC pipe and then get some tin foil and put it over top of a pot and put part of the bow in it or the full bow in it and steam it. Or another good option, if you're just going to do a limb tip, lots of woods, you can actually get away with just boiling it, put it actually in the water, boil it for a couple minutes, and then you can shape the wood like actually pretty crazy. Sinew and horn, I like those for bows. I think it'd be a dream for me to make a horn bow. I never have, and I know just materials alone can cost tons and tons of money. I've talked to a guy, another YouTuber about it, who makes them, and it's insane about how he said, like, expect to spend $3,000 to $4,000 or something for like four bows. And I was like, oh my goodness. And then it takes like a 2 to 3 year process of actually making it because of drying and curing time. It's insane. Wood pigeon outdoors. I do plan on doing the hockey stick idea. I love that. He said use a hockey stick for the Willow Bow series. I think that's fantastic, and I think it would work really well. A bow out of layers of thin wood glued together. I've never done that. Make it more durable. I would imagine it makes it more durable. Like, here, do you mind? My wife's helping me back here. Do you mind grabbing a piece of bamboo and a piece of ipé? What happens when you glue up bamboo and ipé is it really, really hardens it up a lot. And so I wonder if that would make it harder, because I have this, it feels like this not glued together would be extremely difficult. Here's a piece of bamboo. So a thick piece of bamboo and ipé, like this piece of bamboo is still really thick and it just like bends extremely easily. And then if you take just a normal piece of ipé, you can bend it pretty easily as well. But if these were glued together, I couldn't move it at all. So I know it really makes it a lot more rigid. I wonder if that would work if you laminated like, I don't know, six pieces of, thank you. If you laminated like six pieces of pine together or something, I wonder, I don't know. It might be worth a shot. Oh, what's up, Brad? Thank you. Oak for a bow? Yes, oak's a great option. So oak is in hardware stores a lot for people. Normally they have like pine, spruce, and oak or something. Sometimes there's maple, but if you're doing a hardware store bow build, I would go for red oak. Cedar, you can get away with cedar pretty good, red cedar, and then also maple. Those are the three top choices for a hardware store board bow. Aaron, can I make a crossbow? Aaron Mullins. I believe Aaron has videos on YouTube and he made a bow. I'm pretty sure that's you, man. Good video. Also, can I make a crossbow? Very possibly. I have more ideas, and you guys have some of the best ideas, more than I can, man, than I can do right now. But I like to use the word yet, more than I can do yet. So maybe in the future, for sure. Julian, have I ever made a bow from a single piece of wood? Yes, I have. Actually, I'm going to grab, yes, no, can you go in that door and open the door? And it's pretty right. Out of Osage is what I normally make a bow out of, a single piece of wood. I have a piece of Osage here and I'll show you. That's how I actually started in bow making, is making self bows. All you guys, or a lot of you guys, I'm sure, know Clay Hayes. I was like a baby when he started posting videos, and I learned most of my stuff from him, and I started reading some archery books. But what I ended up doing, starts with right. Oh, here it is. We're back. So this is what I start making self bows out of, and I went and cut one of these down when I was young. Honeysuckle locust or black locust. I believe that would work really good. I've never done it though. I don't have experiential knowledge on that. Hockey stick, are those good for bows? We're gonna find out. Pallet wood take work to make a takedown bow from Jeffrey. Jeffrey, I think it would. I would look for an oak pallet. They're rare, but you can find them. You could do one out of pine. The nice thing about it is, like, you just can have fun in the shop with it. And then if you mess it up, it's like no big deal. Why am I holding this? It's like no big deal at all. And it's fun. I would get a 2x4 or something if you're like scared to break good material, and just start working it and learn how to build on something really cheap. And then after you learn on something really cheap, it's much easier to make something with a nicer bow wood. The best thing I've ever done to improve my bow making is break bows on purpose. I literally like with that duct tape bow, you saw that, I pulled that down. One of my Ipe maple bows, I pulled it, and Ipe bamboo bows, I pulled it back to 40 inches as well, and it didn't break, and it slowly started to crack. But that shows you the limits of the wood, and then you kind of get a feel for it, and that helps so much. Would leather work as a bow backing? Yes, it would. Very similar, basically the same as rawhide. Rawhide is a very popular bow backing, and people swear that it's the best bow backing there is. can I make a repeating bow? Like, I can't. Jörg Sprave? I don't know how he says it. I'm not German, but no, I don't know if I can. He just came out with his. I think they manufactured that. That's pretty crazy. For the pallet wood bow, would you need a backing for it? I'd go ahead and put one on. The real answer is no, you shouldn't if you can chase a growth ring, but honestly, I'd put it on just for safety. It just makes me feel a lot better to know that it's not going to blow up in my face. I would put one on is my answer. Heat treating white wood to make it stronger. I don't know. I've never done it. I have no clue if it would make it stronger. I have wondered, like, if you've seen people like vacuum in a vacuum, not a vacuum, but they pull a vacuum in a tube in order to stabilize wood. People do this for wood pins and stuff. Big Jib Bow Companies, he does this for his risers. I wondered if you did that for an entire bow or something, like with white wood, how much stronger that would make it. But Jordan, make a bow like Backyard Bowyer out of PVC. I've considered that, and I've, like, he did PVC bows so well, I never got into them, which kind of doesn't make sense. But, like, he's taught them so well that it's like I could just go learn about it. But I have had such a desire to just, like, try things that I haven't seen people do much. So that's why I haven't gotten to PVC bows yet. But I've heard some great things about them. Can you reinforce your bow with drywall tape? Yes, you can. I've done that. I had a bow that had a crack in the back of it because I didn't chase the growth ring right or whatever it was. And so I went ahead and put fiberglass tape on the back of it, and it fixed it. Or you could just use duct tape. People hate me for that. It worked though. What length was your bowstring for poplar wood bow? This is a great question. I have no clue what the length it is, but I will tell you, for a long bow, get a bowstring that is 3 inches less than the length of the longbow. And when you're measuring the longbow, go from the back of the nock to the back of the nock. That's how I measure longbows. And then 3 inches less for a longbow. And then if you have a recurve bow, it's 4 inches less. It's a question I get a lot, and that'll be pretty much dead on. And then if you're getting a string from me or anybody else, what will happen is, if it's slightly off, you can just twist it up a little bit, and that'll make the string a little shorter, or you can untwist the string a little bit. That'll make it a little longer, and that'll help you know what length of bowstring you need. A bow out of cedar. Yes, you can. Clay Hayes did a red cedar bow build not too long ago. I think that's a pretty good one if you're looking to make one out of cedar. The steps are going to be pretty similar to any other bow, though. What wood would I use for a first-time self-bow? I would use what you have access to. If you have access to, like, if you're in the Midwest and you have access to an Osage orange tree, there's just rows of Osage orange, and people will just, like, give you the wood if you ask them. Go get that. That's going to be phenomenal. That's what I started with. It's a fantastic bow wood. If you have just access to a hardware store, I would start off with oak, maple, or any other hardwood you can find. If you can't even find that, I would just use any wood, pine or anything, because it's just so fun and you can pretty much use any type of wood. I haven't found one type of wood yet that I haven't been able to make some kind of bow out of. Gabriel, I have a PVC flatten, so like cut it in half, heat it up, flatten it out, if that would work as a bow backing. I imagine it would. I feel like I would want to thin it down. I feel like it'd be too thick, but I might have to try that. If I do that as a bow backing, what should I put on the belly? Hey, thank you. If I helped you make your first bow, that's absolutely awesome. That's the goal. I get so pumped about bow making, which kind of, I don't know, it kind of can feel silly, but man, shooting an arrow, like you're shooting a weapon or a projectile through the air, like I guess it might be a guy thing or something, but it's just so fun, like especially when you make it yourself. Hey, Daniel, we can talk about that. If you want to email me at contact@KramerAmmons, I can give you all the details for that and we can get that worked out. Thanks so much. Brad Harding, the answer to your question, what was your question? Must have beginner tools to start making bows? Let me show you something. I can make a bow with these two tools. Yeah, I can actually, and I have. I started when I was like 14 in my parents' house, but I only made like one a year. And then when I got married 5 years ago, moved into an apartment, and I was sitting on the floor of the apartment with these two things on rasping away at some Osage orange that I had cut down. And like, it's not fun. Like, it was actually super fun for me, but like, if you enjoy rasping for 20 hours, you you can do that. Just make sure your wife's not home, and make sure you have a good vacuum to clean it up. Steve, that'd be awesome if you can do that. Bushcraft camp's so fun. What size of stave would be good? This is a question I get all the time. What's your draw length? Your draw length times 2 plus the handle section. So for example, I use an 8-inch handle section. And so if my draw length's 30 inches long, I'm gonna times that by 2, so 60 inches, and then plus the 8-inch handle section, that's 68 inches. So for me, a 68-inch bow is pretty ideal. And that's the type of bow that's going to shoot really smooth for you. Now, if I want a faster bow, I can knock that down depending on the type of bow wood. So I can get down to probably a 64-inch bow and get away with it. The thing is, the shorter the bow you get, the less smooth of a shot you'll probably get. And what that means is it becomes harder to even aim when you're shooting. And so you can get away with shorter bows. I mean, even if it depends on the material, like look at horn bows. You've got like a 2-foot bow, it basically seems like, that they're shooting, but it gets harder to aim accurately with that. Reddick, about ash. Any ideas on how to do ash? If you've had struggle with flat bows, I would just change the design. Like, I would just change it up. Maybe do a long bow, pyramid style bow, something like that. I would just start experimenting with different designs and see what ended up working. I personally haven't used ash, so I can't really speak into that from experiential knowledge, though. Cody, let's go. You're doing the same thing in your garage with a filing set. Yes, that's where it starts. That's so fun. Gary, what's the best type of string to use? That's a great question. Honestly, my favorite is B55 if I'm using a bow I made myself. The reason is it's such a smooth string to shoot. It's so fun and pleasurable. And here's the thing, though. Like, if you use a fast flight string, that's completely fine, and some people prefer that. But the B55 string is so much more forgiving. You'll lose 5 to 10 pounds, maybe up to 15 pounds of speed. But I don't care for that 15 feet per second of speed when it comes to comfortability of shooting. Now, if you have a bow that's like perfectly tailored, or if you have a bow that's a bowyer did a fantastic job, you may not feel a difference. The other pro and con to a fast light strings are going to be louder because they don't stretch as much. So it's going to make more noise in general when you shoot it than a B55 string. Now, you have a Dyneema 97, D97. Now that is a very good string as well that I'm actually doing some testing with right now and should have on the website as well. But personally, I like B55. That's my favorite. What kind of adhesive would you use for a PVC backing? Anything that works with PVC and wood, I guess. What would, maybe an epoxy? I don't think like wood glue would work very good or anything like that. I might try an epoxy. I honestly would do EA40 myself for that. Why one side longer than the other one? Are you talking about the bow I talked about? Because if I said one's longer than the other, I misspoke. So I'm not sure what you're saying there. Have I ever made my own arrows, Gary? I haven't. Well, I take that back. I have, but they were very survival-like. I made them in the woods with kind of a survival bow, and I, you know, just carved them with a pocket knife or whatever. But I haven't made arrows to the extent of trying to make them extremely good. I guess I also have done some dowel rods just from a hardware store, grabbed some dowel rods and made some arrows out of that, but I haven't really gotten into it very much. Ed, planning fiberglass. What are thoughts on using woven fiberglass? Ed, yes, woven fiberglass tape will work really good. I've personally used it. I've seen a lot of people use it. I've used it on probably 5 or 6 bows. And as long as the fiberglass tape is thick enough, you have enough layers on there, I've never seen it fail. Literally never seen that part fail. Wood pigeon outdoors. You tried to find the type on 3 wood glue. Whatever they have in Canada, whatever kind of wood glue, I would just use that. And then generally, if you can just read on there and figure out which one's waterproof, I prefer that because I like to use the bow outside. And I just think, I like the extra strength of a waterproof. But at the same time, if you're going to put a finish on it, you may not need waterproof depending on what kind of finish you choose. Thanks, Daniel. That means a lot. Yes, wood finishes. That's a question I get all the time. What kind of wood finish should you use, or what kind of bow finish should you use? I have a couple, actually. My favorite natural wood finish is true oil. This stuff is gunstock oil. This works extremely good if you want a natural finish. And then also polyurethane. What you can do, though, here's the trick. Because I don't like a glossy finished bow, you can use gloss. No. Use flat polyurethane for the first four coats. And then on your fifth coat, use gloss. And it'll look really good and it won't be too shiny. If you guys want to see any of this, in the link in the description of every single video, I have like an Amazon store. And so I put all my woodworking tools, all my bow finishes, whatever it is, I put it on that store. So if I talk about something, it's probably up there. Reddick, thank you so much. It means a lot to me. Glue for fiberglass tape. I just use wood glue. I've heard some people using some kind of epoxy. Any kind of wood glue works really good. That's all I have knowledge with. Thank you so much, Olympus. Julian. Avocado wood. I've never heard of that. I've never heard of it being used as bow wood. Quick kind of rabbit trail real quick, just for the fun of it. One time I was doing some mission work in the jungle, the Amazon jungle in Peru. And there, what we were doing is we were carrying out some logs out of the jungle for the native people there so that they could build houses. And these logs were out of almond wood. And they were the densest, heaviest thing. I'm not kidding you. Like, it'd be a 4x4x8 foot, like 400 pounds. Okay, let's be realistic. 200 pounds maybe. And it was so heavy that I couldn't carry it myself. We had two people to carry it. We had to hike it a mile out of the jungle. Anyway, my point is I've searched everywhere for almond wood and I can't find it. And that's what they call it. I don't know if it's the exact same. If anybody knows of any almond wood, I would love to get a hold of it to make a bow out of it. Aaron, should you make a video on your draw knife? The answer is yes. If you have a video idea, go do it before you can think about it too much. Hey, Richard, do I have a bamboo, Ipe bamboo back bow video? I have two videos of making fast shooting Ipe bamboo back bows, but today I started the filming process of making a how-to video on it, and I'm going to put that out hopefully on Thursday. So Friday, look for it because it normally takes a little longer than I want it to. Mr. Taurus, thank you so much. That means a lot that I'm able to help you get into bows and bow making and anything like that. That makes me happy, man. Can you push the button on there? I think that shut off for a second, but guys, we're gonna have to wrap it up at this point. Thank you so much for joining me. It's been 30 minutes. I think I'm going to probably do these regularly, and I'll probably move them to Sunday nights, if that's okay with everybody. That'd be a great night for me. Great time to hang out. Bring your bow making questions. We can hang out, talk, have a good time. I really do appreciate all of you guys being here. I'll see all of you guys on the next video.